We say goodbye to that blast of summer for now. It's a bit of a teaser, but we know that there's more down the road. Nick, back to you.
All right, speaking of teasers, Matt, let's get a little tease for the Matt Hayes Show and what's coming up tonight.
Well, it was hot today, and there was a hot site in Niagara Falls on Saturday. Who is that guy? I'm not going to tell you who that guy is right now. You'll have to stay tuned to find out. And more on one of the biggest movie events ever. More on that when CACH News at 6 continues right after this.
Okay, as you can see, Matt Hayes is back. That means it's time for the Matt Hayes Show. And Matt, you've got your interesting take, of course, on entertainment and all things wild and wacky.
Absolutely. We're going to start off with some celebrity sightings. You got me thinking. Who's the most famous person that you have ever encountered just in your travels? Somebody that, you know, you weren't expecting to see.
Apart from my encounters with you.
Yes.
Well, I have to say, let's go back to Ken Welch when I was in university. That was my big celebrity sighting. That was about 10 or 11 years ago. I bumped into Ken one night after the 11 o'clock news, and that was a pretty, made a big impression on me. And now, of course, I work next to him, but who's that?
Well, okay, and that's a good question. Who is that? Why, it's none other than Brad Pitt. And who's hotter than him? What's it like to have to go out of your way to look this ordinary? Although, who looks great after a ride on the Maid of the Mist in Niagara Falls? That's where the Pitts were on Saturday afternoon. Missing from the picture, Angelina. She didn't want to be photographed with the makeup-running Tammy Faye look. And now for something completely different. Another celebrity sighting. Let's take a look and see if you can identify this guy. Now, this guy's been out of the public eye for a long time, and he's aged, I must say, quite a bit. That's Terry Jones. He's 67, with his girlfriend, Anna Soderstrom. Jones has England twittering over the affair that they're having. She's 41 years younger than him. And his 35-year marriage broke up when he began seeing her 4 years ago when she was just 22. For her part, Anna's friends say she is blissfully unconcerned with what anyone thinks and is looking at the bright side of life. Am I the only one who got frustrated with heroes this season? The good guys were bad guys, the bad guys were good guys. It all just started giving me a headache. But as Volume 4, Fugitives, comes to a close, the fight to stop Siler has consequences that will reportedly change everything. In tonight's episode, Nathan faces off against Siler, played by Zachary Quinto, to help him from meeting the president, played by guest star Michael Dorn. And if you know what those two names have in common, then what's coming next is no surprise. Of course, Zachary Quinto plays the young Spock in the new Star Trek film, which opens a week from Friday, and Michael Dorn used to play Worf in Star Trek The Next Generation. Would you believe that lineups have already started forming outside theaters in advance of the Star Trek premiere on May the 8th? We'll take a look. All right, well, I'm kind of lying. These are lineups, but they were formed in Tempe, Arizona today ahead of the world premiere of the new movie X-Men Origins Wolverine, not oranges. I'm sure this is something producers of that film are glad to see, especially after a rough edit of that film was posted on the internet. And finally, how about this for an in-store promotion at your neighborhood grocery store? We now go to Ireland. We have automatic doors. We have a bull escaped from a nearby cattle market, and he's off. It's Black Angus in aisle number 3. See the promotion? If you get tagged by the bull, your meat is going to be half off. Whoa. Watch what happens. The one shopper gets, whoa, he's got to do the emote face. Look out. Now, the owner prides himself in the freshness of his meat, but even he agrees that having it chase you down the aisle is just a little too rare. Watch this one more time. Yeah.
Running of the bulls.
The running
down
of
the
bulls.
Here we go.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
He wasn't knocking too much off the shelves overall.
But the steer did have trouble steering.
Yes, they do.
Indeed. Yes, they do.
Absolutely. And
and that's the Matt Hayes Show.
A little too fresh for something.
That's
all right.
Right.
Thanks, Matt. Well, still to come tonight, we'll take you.